Hey there, it's Lynda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado. And I did skip doing a video yesterday live. I was involved with something, just couldn't break away, but I am coming back with you full force today. And today we're going to talk about something that's important. Most of the time, when I come across brand new people that haven't built a business or people that have failed a lot, they're really reluctant to fail again. Now, I don't mean that failure becomes your constant companion, but I do mean you have to expect that you're not perfect at the very outset. There's no business in the world that you can just absolutely not have some amount of failure. In other words, learning curve is going to be part of the process. You have to be willing to understand that. And it's really hard sometimes to go through that process, that frustrating process of not being good at something. But until you can do that, you're not going to succeed. And that's what I wrote today. If you're not willing to go through the failure or the process it takes to get to success, you probably will not be a success. And so I can talk about a lot of experiences I've had. Well, just recently, just this week, I think it was Tuesday, our company, Power Lead System, which I love to use to build my business online, helps me build leads, helps me build sales. And so they just recently created a new process called the Page Builder. They didn't charge more. It's just another addition to all of the wonderful assets and tools we have inside of that program. And now I'm not trying to actually promote that. I just want to talk about some things that have happened just since that happened. So I'm working on pages and I'm failing constantly. I'm not getting anything done. It took about 12 hours to get my first reasonable page completed, because I failed and failed and failed. But I was determined to succeed, and I did, because I kept at it. And that's what I want to really talk about. There isn't any real, just, you're there. There isn't anything like that. Nobody is just like that, already there. Nobody's that. No matter how good somebody is at something and you say, oh, they're just good at everything, and it makes you feel inferior or like you don't have any kind of skill yourself, there's no such thing as somebody that really actually walks in and knows it all. There's people that are willing to spend the time to get better at it. Now, if you think about anything that you've ever done, your work life especially, I'm quite sure, there's a skill level that's required no matter what you're doing. Now, there were years and years that I did admin work, and there were times when there were so many things I didn't know, and I had to learn them. And they were confusing, they were difficult, and there were many times when it would be easy to throw in the towel. But I wouldn't achieve anything that way. And I wouldn't have gotten paid, obviously. So when you're building a business, it's really no different. You simply have to make a decision. Now, you're not going to get paid by the hour for the amount of hours you might spend doing something. But in the end, you're going to reward yourself with a success, even if it takes 12 hours to build one stupid little capture page. So you have to understand, it's not something that's instant. And I think what separates me from some of the others that are not doing as well is that they're generally not willing to put in whatever time it takes to get to that place where you feel like you've succeeded. Now, it doesn't mean you don't ask questions. It doesn't mean you don't find out. Like, I'll listen to videos constantly to get an idea, and then I'll get an idea, I'll go and do it. Instead of just watching videos, which some people do that too, you want to get to a place where you say, okay, there's the answer. Stop the video. Go do it. And then you find a point after you've done that for a while, that you start to actually have success simply because you do it that much more. Now, you know, there's an old saying, it takes about 10,000 hours to be a success at something. Well, I can say honestly that I've probably put in that amount of time in some of the things I've done. And it doesn't mean you have to do that necessarily. But if you are expecting that all I have to do is just go share this page and I'm on and I'm there, doesn't work that way. Just doesn't work that way. So much of the time, people just want something to be absolutely snap and it's done. Well, I really wish it was that way sometimes, but I also know that people would not grow if things were that easy. And people would not be in business if it was easy. You know, that's actually the opposite of what you probably think. If everybody could just jump in and it was just like that, they'd take it for granted and they wouldn't even do it. But the ones that actually want to do it bad enough that they'll put in the effort and they'll keep after it until they've got it, those are the ones that are actually going to win. So understand something. Nothing is so simple that you get it like this. Most of the time, there is going to be a learning curve. Now, some things are going to be harder than other things. And it doesn't matter. You may not want to do that kind of work. But I do know one thing. If you don't work on yourself and you don't work on your skills, no success is going to come to you. So I'm always constantly putting in the effort and the time to build my skills, both my talking to people kind of skills and my business skills as far as skills I can do, like building pages, for instance. Now, not everybody wants to do that, and that's perfectly fine. We have it set up in such a way that people that don't want to do a whole lot of work can just grab one of our share codes, and they can just make, with a few clicks, they can have their own pages and ready to go. And all they have to do is send traffic to it, and with a little bit of money, you can do that. On the other hand, there are some people like me that likes to do a little bit more because I do understand that it's important to be to work at something and to be unique, because one page that looks like everybody else's isn't going to get you anywhere, because that's what happens in the network marketing field, especially in some of the affiliate programs as well. They give you a basic affiliate link, but if it looks like everyone else's, then you're not going to be unique, are you? If there's 10,000 people in your company or more, and they're all using that same generic link that was given to them, well, what makes you different than any of the others? You have to do something that makes you a little bit stand out and a little bit better than everyone else. And not in a bad way, just simply that you're showing that you are an individual that they might want to be part of. And that's what I try to do and teach others as well. If you want to learn more about that, let's have a talk. Bye for now.